Santa Barbara is one of the most beautiful small towns in the United States. It is located approximately 100 miles to the west-northwest of Los Angeles. Although the references to human habitation date back thousands of years, the first known explorer visiting this area was
Cabrillo
from Portugal, and he was working for the Spanish kingdom. He traveled through this area in 1542. One of the key attractions of Santa Barbara is the Arts and Crafts Show, which is held on the street side every Sunday from morning 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. It has been running continuously for the past 53 years. Artists set up their stalls early in the morning, and you can see various things like paintings, photographs, handicrafts, and so many other things on display as well as sale. Chase Palm Park is a perfect location for holding receptions or small conferences, etc. It also has a shipwreck themed playground for children and has a beautiful view of the seaside, seashore. Santa Barbara is a small town located between seashore and Saint Ynez Mountains. One can walk on the main street along the seashore and enjoy the beauty on both sides. Being a tourist town, there are many hotels, inns, and places for staying. While in Santa Barbara, do not miss the chromatic gate near the Cabrillo Park and the Hilton Hotel. It's a beautiful structure created by artist Herbert Baer, and it's a best place for taking photographs. Cabrillo Boulevard and the State Street, these are two of the best streets for the pedestrians or the tourists to walk and enjoy the beauty of Santa Barbara. There are many museums, including the Moxie, and a variety of restaurants, including seafood joints, which would be very interesting for all the tourists. Amtrak runs from Los Angeles to San Francisco and passes via Santa Barbara. There are very few trains going through Santa Barbara, so the gorgeous railway station is vacant most of the day. Moreton Fig Tree is the largest fig tree in the United States and is a tourist attraction of Santa Barbara. Urban wine tasting centers and various wall murals and the shops, etc., make the walk through the city very interesting and lovable. One of the best tourist attractions is the Stearns Wharf. It is named after its builder, John P. Stearns, who built the wharf in 1878. It served as a longest deep water pier on the West Coast. The wharf faced a few natural disasters,
like the earthquake of 1925 and the fire in 1977, after which it took 6 years to restore the wharf. Then once again in 1998 there was a fire which destroyed the last 100 feet of the wharf, including the restaurant Moby Dick. It was later restored, and now the wharf has 17 businesses on the wharf, like restaurants, wine tasting, museums, ice cream shops, candy shops, etc., where people can come and spend time and enjoy. At the beach near the wharf, we spotted an artist doing beautiful sand sculpture.
We had a great time at the wharf, taking pictures of the albatrosses and pelicans and walking around and enjoying the gorgeous view.
Santa Barbara has an interesting history. This was the place where world's first offshore well was spud. Then secondly, Santa Barbara housed movie studios during the silent movie period, and as many as 1200 films were produced here. Subsequently, the movie industry moved to Hollywood. Longhead Aircraft Company was established on the lower State Street, which tested seaplanes nearby, and it eventually became the Lockheed.
While in Santa Barbara, you could visit the Channel Islands National Park or many beaches, including the Arroyo Burro Beach. You could visit the zoo, the mission, and there are many places worth visiting. If you have liked this video, subscribe to my channel and see other travel videos. Thank you.